We've got this unusual ecosystem in which we have incredibly high biodiversity. And I spent my childhood years in that landscape. As my father fished, I'd go out and look at things and wander off in the forest. Out of the 15,000 square kilometers of land in Sri Lanka's southwestern quarter, about a third is occupied by tea and rubber plantations. As a result of that, the whole of the historical biodiversity in those areas has been destroyed. We can't turn the clock back to the Garden of Eden. That's never going to happen. But if you're going to turn the clock forward, how do we save as much of the diversity as we can? I got the Rolex Award for the Agropathana Montane Forest Restoration Initiative in the year 2000. The enhanced profile that Rolex gave me really helped me take my work forward. As these tea gardens are abandoned when they're not productive or not profitable, we have the opportunity of returning them to forest. If we do nothing, what happens is the landscape is very quickly taken up by alien species. We plant shade trees because they help the Sri Lankan species of trees to come up beneath them. They provide enough shade that those alien invasive plants can't grow any longer because they like direct sunlight. 23 years later, it is still going on and it's doing very well, and we've got something to show for it. For example, within 10 years of beginning the restoration work, we found that the majority of the amphibians in highland forests had come into the land and colonized it. They weren't there before, but they'd moved in. It's a very slow process. 300-400 years of work is going to have to go into this. This is not something that I can do single-handedly. So now I'm trying to build a cohort of younger people specialized in biology who can then take on this kind of work and take it to the future. But there were huge gaps in knowledge of Sri Lanka's biodiversity because there was no literature in the local language of 80% of the people in this country. So we had publishing literature in Sinhala as one of the priorities. And from the outset, when we started this project, we built visitor accommodation on the property so that university students, researchers from all over the world could come and work there. And now some of those people are 40 years old and they've become professors in university and they've got students themselves. So that makes me very proud. When you plant a tree, you're probably not going to live to see that grow into a giant oak. People 100 years from now can look back and see what we wrote today.